Solo, A Star Wars Story is now out in theaters for fans to see. Ron Howard's vision of a Star Wars movie, the Han Solo film set 10 years before the events of A New Hope. This is Mike Zero here. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, as you all know, in case you guys didn't catch it, I saw the movie late last night and I was able to do a spoilers review. If you guys would like to go ahead and check that out, I will link it below in the description and in the comments section. So if you guys did go ahead and see the movie, go ahead and check that out. But looking past all of this, looking at Solo, A Star Wars Story, which, by the way, there will be some spoilers in this video. Not too much, but there will be some. So just be aware about that. If you guys don't want to get any spoilers in your head, I would X out of this video as of right now. Anyways, looking at Solo, A Star Wars Story, we do know that Alden Ehrenreich is signed on for multiple Star Wars movies, which is said to be Solo follow-ups or Solo sequels, if you will, within the Disney Star Wars canon. Now, looking at the entire Star Wars franchise, we have a lot of projects currently in the works, one of which, like I say, is of course Solo sequels in some way, shape, or form. Now, toward the end of this movie, we have that moment in which Woody Harrelson's character, Tobias Beckett, says that he plans on going to Tatooine for one last big job for a big shot gangster on Tatooine. Now, this was an indirect reference to Jabba the Hutt, and this actually does open up a lot of possibilities, especially for the ending of Solo, because we do know that both Han and Chewbacca are going to Tatooine because of what he heard from Tobias Beckett. So looking at all of this, originally there was a specific symbol that was supposed to be a whole lot more significant in the film that apparently was ultimately scrapped or scaled down from the movie, that was to tease the Solo, A Star Wars Story sequel. And if you guys go ahead and check out one of the Facebook ads, as you can see right here, a lot of you guys may be wondering, what is that symbol? Have you guys seen that before? Well, you guys may be familiar with it if you guys are very familiar with a very iconic character such as Jabba the Hutt. Now, this is actually the Kajayak symbol, which was a hut structure both for family and the crime gangs. Jabba and his nephew actually belonged to such organizations. And if you guys actually go ahead and look at the original trilogy and look way close on Jabba's right arm, you will see that exact same symbol tattooed onto his arm. So that was a direct Jabba the Hutt reference that was actually ultimately scaled down from Solo, A Star Wars Story within a Facebook ad for Solo, A Star Wars Story, and that was essentially a tease of what's to come in the future for a Solo sequel. So the reason why I'm very much excited about seeing yet another Solo sequel, and like I say, and like I have said before in the past, I don't think it'll be dubbed like Solo, A Star Wars Story 2. I think it's just going to be another spin-off movie that will feature Han Solo, and he will be used as a side plot, and that will be a great way to introduce Tatooine into one of the other spin-off films. For example, if there's an Obi-Wan Kenobi movie featuring Tatooine, obviously there's going to be, right? They could definitely have a side plot of Han Solo going into Jabba's palace and setting up a deal with the crime lord, and that could be like one scene in and on itself where Alden Ehrenreich could very well be in the Obi-Wan Kenobi Star Wars movie, as well as Jabba the Hutt. Think about it, with the Obi-Wan Kenobi film, we all expect to see Jabba, right? And with that being said, the fact that Jabba would be there, it would make a whole lot of sense since Disney is trying to go down the Marvel route by interconnecting all these different characters. Why not have Han Solo just step in and set up a deal with Jabba and then leave and then go back to the Obi-Wan Kenobi story and the whole entire plot of things with that? But looking at that symbol, that Kajayak symbol was actually a hut structure both for family and the crime gangs out there, but that both Jabba and his nephew belonged to. So it's really interesting to see that that symbol was supposed to be a whole lot more significant in the movie, and that is a symbol that's actually tattooed on Jabba's right arm if you guys look very, very close. So that tells us right then and there that Jabba the Hutt will be one of the main figures in the Solo sequel, whatever those sequels are going to be, you know, used as, whether it's going to be just Han Solo as a side plot in a future spin-off film, or maybe perhaps it will be a direct Solo, A Star Wars Story 2 with the number 2 on it, which I don't think they would do that. But looking at Jabba the Hutt, this is something that I'm honestly very excited to see. I'm a big Jabba fan. I was always a fan of him. Ever since I got Star Wars A New Hope on VHS as a kid, that's when I was first introduced to the character. Then, as I saw, you know, Return of the Jedi, that was my favorite part of Jabba. Completely practical, it was amazing to see him on screen with Luke Skywalker, that whole entire, you know, scene with Lando Calrissian, Leia, Han, Chewbacca, C-3PO, R2-D2. It was just such a classic moment, and to see Jabba on the big screen would be a wish come true. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about this. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you also very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Again, no.